Donegal was the location for a major military exercise involving the defence forces from the 4th Western Brigade. For 3 days, over 400 troops took part in operations around Loch Garten. It was one of the largest military exercises to be staged in the region in recent years, and was designed to prepare troops for overseas deployment with the defence forces. The exercise saw troops from several infantry battalions coming to the county by air, sea, and road. Outlining the nature of the exercise, GOC Brigadier General Gerry Hegarty explained what was happening.
This is a battalion exercise, the big brigade exercise for the year. And it's happening up here around Lake Garten, beautiful scenery. But it's very serious stuff for the lads because we're a training battalion to go overseas in peacekeeping operations. And the question is, you might ask, why are we doing a conventional battalion attack? Well, the wisdom is that you train up to come down to peacekeeping operations. So what we're seeing here now is a full battalion in attack, and they have three main objectives, and they're out there in front of me. We'll have air support, we'll have, they can hear the bombs going off there as the troops make their attack, starting off that big hill up there. But this is an objective, these are realistic objectives for the battalion.
Irish troops have been deployed abroad in peacekeeping operations in recent years, and he stressed the importance of proper training.
Of course, we've had a lot of trouble in peacekeeping operations, and we tend now to be in Chapter 7 peacekeeping missions, which are peace-enforcing missions. All the missions really since Bosnia, since Srebrenica, that the UN have mandated, tend to be at the sharp end, if you like, peace-enforcing. So we have to be prepared for this. But this is conventional training, as I said at the start. Conventional training is at the high end.
Given the scale of the operations, exercises like this require a considerable amount of careful planning.
There are 440 soldiers involved in this attack here. And you can take it out, it takes a lot more soldiers to get those people into position. So logistically, yes, this is a huge effort. We had to get troops from Galway, from Athlone, and from Finner Camp up here. And they've been up here for the past few days. So to feed them, to house them, to transport them, some came by ship, some came by air, some came by truck. So it is a huge logistics effort, but that's part of the training.
He also highlighted the importance of the Reserve Defence Forces, who play a key role.
I always say, without the reserve forces, exercises like these would nearly be impossible for us because of all the other things we do. As well as this type of training, we have operations taking place every day of the week in support of the civil power, and we've also got troops overseas. So without the reserve giving us a hand, we wouldn't be able to mount exercises like this.
Brigadier General Hegarty then explained how operations would be completed on the final day.
Well, this day will come to a close when the battalion takes these three objectives that we see in front of us here. It's going to be a very, very tough effort. As you can see, the terrain here is very, very tough. But when these objectives are taken and all the troops are accounted for, the exercise will then come to a close.
Given the demanding terrain and testing weather conditions experienced at times during the 3 days, it was widely acknowledged that this exercise was invaluable in the training and development of Irish troops for future operations. Chris Ashmore, Wallace Media, Garten Lake, Donegal.